Hi, today we're going to look at main slave flash. Hi, I'm Mick Sandler, and today we're going to look at main slave flash. Looks like a bulb, screws into our ceramic bulb holder. It's got a test button on the side, allows you to flash. It's also got a sink socket, 2.5mm, and a sink cable is provided. Now, on the other end of that is a PC socket, and most cameras these days don't have it, so you would need an adapter on your hot shoe to use that. This flash can be triggered by any flash, and an on-camera flash, and we'll show you how to do that in a minute. On this slave flash, you've got a light that shows that it's connected to the mains, a light that shows you that it's recycled, obviously the strobe, and also a photo cell. So this photo cell will trigger from any flash. This is our setup. We've got a slave flash screwed into one of our ceramic bulb holders. It's got a switch on the back to switch it on and off. We have a shoot-through umbrella attached to that, which just slipped in. We've got a test button, which we can flash. Now, we're going to try this out and see how effective this is. These are very inexpensive, and so really you can have a portrait set up with very little money. Right, this is the model we're going to use. It is a mannequin, not a live model. We're going to take a couple of shots with this, showing you just what the slave flash can do. Now, on the camera, we're using the pop-up flash, and on this particular camera, you can set the setting at a really low rate. We're set the on-camera flash to 128, which doesn't affect the picture. But what it does do is set off the slave flashes. So we've got our model here. We've got a off to the this side. We've got the shoot through umbrella with the slave flash in, which is 2 meters away. And we're running on 200 ISO. We've taken a reading under the chin like so. And we've got a flash setting of F8. So, no more to do, we'll show you what the result of that is. So as you can see, with one light, the result isn't bad. You can see the shadows are fairly soft because of the umbrella is spreading light. But we are 2 meters away, and this is, we're at ISO 200. So, very little cost there. Straight away, you've got a portrait set up. Now we're going to try, we've got a white background and our model is a meter away from that, and we're just going to put another slave flash on the floor and take another shot. And you can see that other shot now that we've whitened the background. So with that two flash set up, bang, we're there. You can use the obviously the setup in a different configuration. So you could have a key light and then have that light further away as the fill light. You do need to have the camera flash behind the slave flashes just to so that they see the flash from the camera. If you can't change your camera flash, you can't reduce it down, then you just put a little baffle across in front of the flash to direct it towards where the slave flash is, and that will set it off. So, you know, from a really low cost system, you can't go wrong. Now, I'm Mick Sadler, thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, and if you want any videos, let us know. This is such a simple setup, it's worth giving it a go for the amount of money it costs. You know, if you've already got light stands, all you need to buy is the bulb holder and the slave flash. and you're away, and obviously the umbrella.